post-production on the documentary Who Will Write Our History? And it's the story of the secret buried archives from the Warsaw Ghetto. It's not a well-known story, and it's probably one of the most important untold stories of the Holocaust.
How did the idea to make this documentary come about?
Well, when I was here with Above and Beyond, my other film, and the director of Above and Beyond, Roberta Grossman, as we were shooting Above and Beyond, started telling me about a book that she had bought the movie rights to called Who Will Write Our History by Sam Cassow. And she described the story, and you know, it's a story of a man named Emanuel Ringelblum, who was a historian and an activist. And in the Warsaw Ghetto, he realized that he needed to collect documents and have some kind of proof of what was going on in the ghetto. And at one point, he realized that he probably would not survive the Warsaw Ghetto, and he gathered a group together, and everybody wrote diaries and collected essays and every aspect of life and death in the Warsaw Ghetto in the hopes that these documents would survive. In fact, they buried these documents in tin cans and milk cans and tin boxes. And you know, so maybe they would scream the truth to the world of what the Nazis had done. And Roberta was telling me about this book and asked me if I was interested in working with her on the next film. And since we did a good job with Above and Beyond, and she captured my attention right away, and I caught, you know, it was a little bit contagious, her enthusiasm. So I joined up with her to do this film that will hopefully be out in January.
Well,
it was 1946, and the search for the buried archive of the Warsaw Ghetto had not even begun. Just finding a certain house among the rubble was difficult enough, but to find a cellar within a cellar in which the archive was hidden would be almost like an archaeological expedition.
It was on the third anniversary of the Warsaw Ghetto uprising, and there was a commemoration. And then Rachel Auerbach, who was a survivor, she just got up and said, look, enough talk, enough speeches. There is a treasure buried underneath the ruins of the Warsaw Ghetto. And I won't rest until I'm sure that you've found it.
These were the last days of September 1939. On one day in that series of black days, a Yiddish poet came to see me and brought me news that Emanuel Ringelblum was looking for me.
Emanuel Ringelblum was a historian as well as a community organizer. At a time when the Jewish leadership was running away, Ringelblum approaches Auerbach as she was planning to flee Warsaw and go to Galicia, where she came from. And Ringelblum asked her to run a soup kitchen, saying, we don't all have the right to run.
Ringelblum began keeping a daily diary immediately from the first day of the war.
Saturday, October 12th, 1940. The loudspeaker announced the division of the city into three parts, German, Polish, and Jewish. Gradually, a ghetto is being established.
Ringelblum's mission was to document Jewish life during the war. And then at some point in 1940, he understood that this really had to be a collective effort.
I selected capable people, and as a result, the co-workers of the Oneg Shabbos have constituted a uniform body, ruled by a single spirit, pervaded by a single idea.
We gather every Sabbath, a group of activists in the Jewish community, to discuss our diaries and writings. We want our experiences to be impressed upon the memories of future generations and on the memory of the whole world.
The Jews started to write. Everyone did. Journalists, authors, teachers, community workers, even children. Everyone was fully aware of the importance of his part in completing the task.
More than 60 members of the Oneg Shabbos collected artifacts such as German pronouncements, official and underground newspapers, labels on ghetto goods, white Jewish ribbons with the blue star of David. Jokes and the songs of beggars came flowing in. The Oneg Shabbos collected diaries and wrote works about refugees, illness, smuggling, about the situation of the Jewish child, the role of women, and about hunger.
You don't really need guns to fight. You could fight with paper and pen. This was a battle too, a battle for memory.
Wednesday, July 22nd, 1942. The news about the expulsion of the Jews is spreading like lightning through the ghetto. Mothers and children wander around like lost sheep. Where is my child?
On July 26th, there was an extraordinary meeting of the archive. They decided that it was time to bury everything that they had collected so far. There was no time to lose.
I handed over the last torn out pages from my diary. It could happen that not even one witness will survive to tell our tragedy.
As they were filling the boxes, they were writing their last wills and testaments.
We were not afraid of the risk. We understood that we were creating a piece of history, and this is more important than single lives. I would love to live to see the moment in which the great treasure will be dug up and scream the truth at the world.
Scene 33, scene 4 alpha,
scene 29,
183.